Can I say thanks for the things you've done for me? Things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love to me. The boy said,
good morning and welcome to Prayer and Devotion on this Saturday, March 20th, starting off with my tribute to God be the glory, and that was Andre Crouch, who was the one who, I'm not sure if he wrote that, but he's the one that's attributed to that song. I know many others have sung that as well, but to God be the glory. So today, the title of our devotion is Glory. So we're going to be talking about John 5 and the theme of glory. So let me take a minute and say good morning to Barbara and Esther. I'm glad you're here, holding you both in prayer today. Good morning, Daniel and Priscilla. Welcome, holding you in prayer. Good morning, Ethel and Donna. Did I already say Donna? No, I didn't. Good morning, Donna. Holding you both in prayer today. Good morning, Augusta and Michelle. Welcome. Holding you in prayer. Good morning, Beatrice and Lisa. I'm glad you're here. Holding you in prayer. Good morning, Ingrid and Betty. Welcome. Holding you in prayer today. And good morning, Georgiana and Margaret. I'm glad you're here as well. So it's good to be with all of you today, holding all of you in prayer. We're looking at John 5, and we're just looking at verse 44 today. The Gospel of John, chapter 5, verse 44. So as you turn to that in your Bible, I want to introduce myself. My name is Cindy Stauffer, and I am blessed to serve as the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. And to have this chance with you every morning to gather. I know Hillary was with you yesterday, but it's good to be with you today. So let's take a look at John chapter 5, verse 44. And I know it's a good one because I've written brackets around this one. How can you believe when you accept glory from one another and do not seek the glory that comes from the one who alone is God? How can you believe when you accept glory from one another and do not seek the glory that comes from the one who alone is God? So our devotion today is entitled Glory, and it comes from Henry Nouwen's book, Show Me the Way, which is a Lenten devotional book. And this is what he says about the word glory. I have gradually become aware how central this word glory is in John's gospel. There is God's glory, the right glory that leads to life. And there is human glory, the vain glory that leads to death. All through his gospel, John shows how we are tempted to prefer vain glory over the glory that comes from God. Human glory is always connected with some form of competition. Human glory is the result of being considered better, faster, more beautiful, more powerful, or more successful than others. Glory conferred by people is glory that results from being favorably compared to other people. The better our scores on the scoreboard of life, the more glory we receive. The glory comes from upward mobility. The higher we climb on the ladder of success, the more glory we collect. But this same glory also creates our darkness. Human glory based on competition leads to rivalry, and rivalry carries within it the beginning of violence, and violence is the way to death. Thus, human glory proves to be vain glory, false glory, mortal glory. How then do we come to see and receive God's glory? In his gospel, John shows that God chose to reveal his glory to us in his humiliation. That is the good, but also disturbing news. God, in his infinite wisdom, chose to reveal God's divinity to us, not through competition, but through compassion. That is, through suffering with us. God chose the way of downward mobility. Every time Jesus speaks about being glorified and giving glory, he always refers to his humiliation and death. It is through the way of the cross that Jesus gives glory to God, receives glory from God, and makes God's glory known to us. The glory of the resurrection can never be separated from the glory of the cross. The risen Lord always shows us his wounds. Thus, the glory of God stands in contrast to the glory of people. People seek glory by moving upward. God reveals glory by moving downward. If we truly want to see the glory of God, we must move downward with Jesus. This is the deepest reason for living in solidarity with poor, oppressed, and handicapped people. They are the ones through whom God's glory can manifest itself to us. They show us the way to God, the way to salvation. We don't want to hear this. This is really hard stuff. Upward mobility. And throughout the devotions that we've been looking at from Henry Nouwen, he talks about this downward movement of God. It is so the opposite of what we see in the world. Humans, we are always striving for the next big thing, the next promotion, the next accolade, the whatever's going to move us towards the top. That seems to be our goal. The way up is always, and competition is so big in our world. Who's gonna be the top? The team that wins, the person that gets to be valedictorian, and the list goes on. And it isn't that God doesn't want us to do our best. Of course, we are called. There are good things that come out of these. But if this is the glory that we are seeking, it will fail us. It is temporary. It does not lead us closer. In many ways, it leads us further apart from one another. And so there, it is not bad to want to do well in life. But if that is the glory we seek, we will miss the point. Jesus teaches us that the glory, God's glory, comes in the vulnerable, in those, we seek God, we find God more fully, in those who are walking through places of oppression, when we walk alongside them, when we notice it in ourselves. I mean, that's the thing. We try to hide our vulnerabilities. We do everything we can to make sure that people only see us as strong. But Jesus talked about his glory by being raised up on a cross. Where is there glory in that? That's very hard for us to understand. But I know that when I have sat with powerful people, worldly powerful people, who tell me that they are struggling, that they are in a place of, where they need me to pray for them, I see them in a very different way. I understand when they're vulnerable enough to say, I need help, or I need you, or I need rest, that too, it changes. It changes the way, not only that I see them, but it changes our connection with one another. There is power in our willingness to be vulnerable. Not all the time, but to say, I need you. We need one another. We need God. And the more that we try to go the upward mobility, the upward route, the more and more we find ourselves isolated. If the only glory we seek is the vain human glory, we will never truly see the gift that God gives us, the gift of community, the gift of connection, the gift of knowing that even in our places of weakness, that we are not alone. The resurrected God was a resurrected God with wounds. That is important, that the scars were still there. Jesus didn't come back without anything to represent what he had been through. It is the things that we walk through that and our willingness to let those wounds be a healing to the world, right? That's what they're called to be. They're not to knock us down, but they are to be a healing to the world. When we acknowledge that we have wounds, that we have walked through things, that God has been with us in those times, but yes, that we are not perfect. It is those places that allow for connection and healing in our world. And so glory, let us come back to the word glory. Why are we seeking glory? Glory from one another and not seeking the glory that we find in Jesus. That is the answer for us. The cross is a moment of beautiful glory, painful, but beautiful, forgiving, grace-filled, merciful. It's just unbelievable that our God would love us that way. That is the glory that Jesus shows us. And the question is, are we able to take that same journey? Tomorrow we're going to be talking about sacrifice in worship, the call to sacrifice, and what does it mean for us to take up our cross and follow. It's not an easy walk, but it is the one that leads to life. So let us pray. Good and gracious God, we admit that too often we are so wrapped up in receiving glory, human glory, in this world, that we fail to see your glory. Turn us around, Lord. Turn us toward life. Help us to find you in the midst of the broken places of our world, in the midst of our own brokenness. Lord, we mourn for the way that our world has separated us. We mourn for our Asian American Pacific Islander brothers and sisters who are experiencing racism, for our Black and Brown brothers and sisters who daily experience all kinds of pain just because of the color of their skin. Lord, we know that that is not your intent. And as long as we continue to be in competition with one another, we will never fully see your face in the faces of one another. So turn us around, Lord, and turn us back. Help us, lead us to the cross. Remind us of the glory that leads to life. We ask all of this, Lord Jesus, in your precious name, as together we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. It was good to be with all of you today. looking forward to seeing you tomorrow in worship at 11. Tomorrow is the last before Palm Sunday. I can't believe we're almost at Holy Week. Gosh, where does the time go? But looking forward to being with you tomorrow in worship. And there's also going to be a prayer vigil that I'm going to help prepare right now, that our central region of the United Methodist Church in New Jersey, we are leading a prayer vigil, a Zoom prayer vigil, tomorrow at 3 p.m. to stand in solidarity. We have many Asian American colleagues especially in this conference, and we stand in solidarity with them. So I invite you to that prayer vigil tomorrow at 3 p.m. on Zoom. I'll make sure that it gets up on our Facebook as well, so you can join us for that time. Holding all of you in prayer, remember, God loves you, my friends, and so do I. I'll see you tomorrow in worship. Bye, friends.